हे सेशन पूर्ण 10 सेशनच सीरीज जे आहे, हे सीरीज आम्ही पूर्ण मेंटल आणि स्पिरिच्युअल दोन गोष्टींवरती फोकस करण्याचा प्रयत्न केलेला आहे. आणि म्हणून तुम्हाला या सीरीज मधून दिसून येईल की ते टॉपिक्स जे आपण कव्हर करण्याचा प्रयत्न करीत आहोत, ऑल दिस टॉपिक्स आर डीलिंग विथ आयदर मेंटल लाईफ ऑर द स्पिरिच्युअल लाईफ दॅट वन हॅज टू लिव्ह ऑन दिस अर्थ. वी डू नॉट नो आफ्टर दिस अर्थ व्हॉट विल आर लाईफ बी, बट जोपर्यंत आपण अर्थ वरती आहोत तोपर्यंत आपण मेंटल आणि स्पिरिच्युअल गोष्टीला तरी निदान या काळात प्राधान्य दिलं पाहिजे. काही गोष्टी आपल्या आजूबाजूला अनपेक्षितपणे घडतात आणि वी डू नॉट नो देर आर व्हेरी मेनी रिझन्स. आता तुम्ही यूथ आहात, तुम्ही सगळं बघता पाहता, तुमच्यापासून ते काही लपवण्यासारखा काही प्रश्न नाहीये. परंतु सुशांत सिंग राजपूत सारख्या आपल्या बॉलिवूडच्या ऍक्टरच्या जीवनामध्ये जे काही झालं त्याने फक्त यूथच नाही खूप लोक डिस्टर्ब आहेत आणि या परिस्थितीमध्ये त्याचा परिणाम आपल्या जीवनावर कुठे होऊ नये. कारण आपण अशा प्रकारचं काही चुकीचं बघत राहिल्यानंतर आपल्याही मनात काही विचार सतावत राहतात. अनेक वेळेला आपल्या मनात खूप असे प्रॉब्लेम्स असतात, खूप असे इमोशन्स असतात जे आपण एक्सप्रेस करत नाहीत, आपण बोलत नाही आणि म्हणून त्या प्रॉब्लेमशी आपण सतत स्ट्रगल करत राहतो. हे सेशनचं जो काही आउटकम असेल तो वेगळा असेल, परंतु इंट्रोड्यूस करताना मला एक गोष्ट तुम्हाला फार जवळून सांगायची आहे, फार इम्पॉर्टंटली समजून सांगायची आहे. ती म्हणजे इफ यू हॅव सम डिफिकल्टी, प्रत्येकाला डिफिकल्टीज आहे, डोंट थिंक की हा मनुष्य एवढा याच्याकडे पैसा आहे, हे सगळं आहे, प्रॉपर्टी आहे, याच्याकडे ही गाडी आहे, त्याकडे काही डिफिकल्टी नाही. त्यांच्याकडे जास्त डिफिकल्टी असतात. सो डोंट थिंक की माझ्याकडे हे आहे ते आहे म्हणजे मला डिफिकल्टी नाही आहेत. आय हॅव इन माय प्रिस्टूड एक्सपिरियन्स सम केसेस लाईक दिस वेअर पीपल आर इन मिलियन्स बट त्यांचे प्रॉब्लेम पण तेवढेच जास्त आहे. सो डोंट थिंक की आपल्याकडे हे नाही म्हणजे आपल्याला प्रॉब्लेम आहे किंवा आपल्याकडे ते नाही म्हणजे प्रॉब्लेम आहे. प्रत्येकाला डिफिकल्टी आहे. रिचेस्ट ऑफ द रिच पर्सन अँड पुअरेस्ट ऑफ द पुअर पर्सन. आणि म्हणून ह्या परिस्थितीमध्ये आपल्याला काय केलं पाहिजे, व्हॉट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू टॉक टू समवन. तुमच्या घरात आई वडील आहेत, कधी कधी आपल्याला मम्मी डॅडीशी कम्फर्टेबल वाटत नाही, मग फ्रेंड्स आहेत, फ्रेंड्स नसले टीचर्स आहेत, आपले रिलिजियस लीडर्स आहेत आपल्या आजूबाजूला ऐकणारे काही मोठी लोक आहेत, त्यांच्याशी आपल्याला कम्फर्टेबल वाटत आणि एक चांगलं प्रोफेशनल सिक्रेट समजून आपण बोलायला पाहिजे आणि आपण पण आपल्या बाजूने ते एक गोष्ट चांगल्या प्रकारे पकडून ठेवायला पाहिजे जे आम्ही प्रीस्ट लोक आमच्या कन्फेशन मध्ये वापरत असतो की कन्फेशनल सिक्रेट पकडत असतो. कोणी आपल्याला काही शेअर केलं म्हणजे आपण जाऊन दुनियाभर सांगत फिरत नाही. सो वी नीड टू मेंटेन टू सिक्रेट्स इन द सोसायटी. फर्स्ट इज कॉल्ड कन्फेशनल सिक्रेट विच इज बाइंडिंग ऑन अस अँड सेकंड इज द प्रोफेशनल सिक्रेट दॅट वी ऑल ऑफ अस नीड टू कीप इन ऑर्डर टू बिल्ड द पर्सनॅलिटी. आपला द होल मोटो ऑफ आर लाईफ शुड बी ऑन बिल्डिंग द पर्सनॅलिटी अँड नॉट टू डिस्ट्रॉय दॅट पर्सन. हा एक महत्वाचा गुण आपण शिकला पाहिजे. आणि जितकं आपल्याला लोकांसाठी चांगलं करता येईल, त्यांचं जीवन जेवढं चांगलं घडवता येईल, त्यांचं लाईफ जितकं चांगलं मोल्ड करता येईल, तो आपण देश आपल्या डोळ्यासमोर ठेवला पाहिजे. कधी कोणाशी काही बोलून त्यांना डिस्टर्ब करण्यापेक्षा आपण समाजामध्ये खूप कितीतरी चांगल्या गोष्टी करू शकतो. या दिवसामध्ये खूप असे चांगले स्पीकर्स आपल्याशी संवाद साधणार आहेत. At the beginning of this series, it is my humble request to you, listen to them carefully. Take down some notes, make some personal notes for your life आणि काहीतरी त्याच्यातून प्रयत्न करा, काहीतरी पॉझिटिव्ह आपल्या जीवनामध्ये आणण्याचा प्रयत्न करा. तेच नाही, नॉट ओनली फॉर मायसेल्फ बट ऑल्सो फॉर द सोसायटी ऍट लार्ज. मी फक्त माझ्यासाठी नाही शिकलं पाहिजे, तर मी जे काही शिकलेलो आहे त्याचा वापर मला सोसायटीमध्ये चांगल्या प्रकारे नीतिमूल्य पसरवण्यासाठी, व्हॅल्यूज पसरवण्यासाठी करता आलं पाहिजे. सो यू आर लर्निंग शुड बी ऑन द टू वे ट्राफिक, लाईक वन साईड फॉर युअर सेल्फ अँड द अदर साईड फॉर द अदर पर्सन. देर इज अ जॉय इन बिल्डिंग समवन्स लाईफ. there's joy, and that joy nobody else will give you in the world. If you are really participating in building up someone's life, that activity, that platform will give you a real joy. I don't want to take it very long, my introduction. Dear friends, thank you very much for responding to our call and being present here. We shall enjoy this session, and there is time for interaction in the second session. There is time for interaction. I'm not prolonging too much, but I am concluding on this note that learn for yourself and use it for the society. Thank you very much.
Good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure for me to introduce our speaker today, who's going to talk to us and guide us about fear and anxiety. So talking about Miss Linda, she is an assistant professor in psychology at St. Xavier's College, Mumbai for over 25 years. Ma'am is a counseling psychologist associated with Prafulta, a Salesian initiative, which is the largest NGO in the area of mental health in Mumbai. She is involved in training, supervision, teaching of counselors, both at St. Xavier's and Prafulta. The areas of interest include adolescence issues, crisis handling, suicide prevention, and geriatric care. A hearty welcome to you, ma'am. Over to you.
All right. Welcome and good evening, all of you. It's the first topic that we're doing with in the beginning. That's called dealing with fear and anxiety. And being a teacher, being a counselor.
Ma'am, I think you've muted yourself.
Got it? Hello?
Yes, we can hear you now.
All right. So starting with a story, I'll tell you a simple story where a little boy was on the beach and he was going with on the beach with his grandfather. And as he was walking on the beach, he saw a lot of starfish on the beach. So he carried one of them and he put it in the water. His grandfather walked away and he continued picking up one of them, each one of them, and putting in the water. After some time, his grandfather told him that what you're doing, so many are there, we will never finish and it's of no use. And the little boy, who was just 6 years old, told his grandfather, he took another starfish on the sea. He picked it up, he put it in the sea and he told his grandfather, for this one, it makes a difference. And to start with fear and anxiety, what I'd like to say is there's a lot of people and audience listening. Even if it makes a difference to one person, it's fine. And looking at your questions, I have incorporated some of the slides. But if there's something else that you require, you're welcome to interact in either English or Marathi. So going to the next one, what is fear? First of all, you must understand that fear is very, very real. It's an emotion. We all feel frightened. As a child, you get frightened of the dark. When you're a little older, you get frightened of animals. When you're an adolescent, you're frightened whether people will like you, like your post on Instagram, whether you'll get friends in college, whether you'll get a girlfriend or a boyfriend. And as you grow a little older, you feel, will I pass? Your parents are very frightened. Are you going to college? Are you attending classes? What are you using your money? So they are frightened. Your parents are also frightened of medical tests. You are frightened of exams and they are frightened of medical tests. They go to check their blood pressure. Their blood pressure is high before they check. Frightened. So what is fear? It's very real. It's very concrete. I can say that we all have our fears. I was really frightened. None of the volume was working yesterday when both Sanya and Rehan were testing. So I was wondering, like, how are we going to manage? It's very concrete, which means that I'm not frightened of everything. I was only frightened that okay, this is not working, what to do? It is present, which means that it is just now, it's happening now. I can clearly say this is what I'm worried about. It is age related. Now, it doesn't mean that you're older, so you won't get frightened. Older people are frightened today about losing their children, their spouse. They're worried about whether I'll remember, whether something will happen to me, whether I'll lose my job. And little bit of gender and culture. Why gender is because many people believe that women can be frightened of some things and men should not be frightened. So gender influences us and culture. For example, I stay in Mumbai, you stay in Vasai. In Mumbai, near college or anywhere, there is no chance of seeing a snake. So I'm not really worried about it. But because you stay in a place like Vasai where there is still greenery, the chances of seeing a snake, being a little careful, is there. So it is culture related. When we talk about culture, we are also not worried. As a teacher for 25 years, when I go to class and if somebody does something wrong, I'm very strict with them. I don't have to worry. I will shout, I will correct. I know that no one in my class will ever pick up a gun and shoot or aim it because the culture doesn't allow it. There is the culture or shista, as we call it, in our whole education, to respect the teacher, to respect the priest. And there is the respect that no one will pick up a gun or even back answer really to you. So gender and culture influence our fears. Just now, we will see the culture of fear is absolutely influenced highly by the media, social media, and the media that we have access to, whether it's the it's probably the television or even if it's the video or anything that you're watching about. Now, what is anxiety? Anxiety is not an emotion and it's not something that all of us feel. So earlier I told you that I was frightened and that is wrong. What I was really feeling is anxiety. I'm not frightened of the session, what happened. It is future oriented. Udya kasa chalnaar? Awaaz enaar, nahi enaar. It's abstract. I can't really tell sometimes what's happening. It's apprehension. Means I'm feeling something in myself, but I don't know what it is. Fear is I'm frightened of the snake. The snake goes away, I'm all right. Here, this is the whole day it will go on. Many times we are not able to say what is the source, kuthun yeta he, kashavarun yeta te pan maiti nahi. And it's not common to all, which means that someone else, when Sanya and Rehan were telling me, explaining to me, they were not anxious. They were very comfortable and calm. So I spoke to a friend and I said, how will I do this session? And they said, no, it's very simple. It is all right. So it's not common to all. Anxiety is very, very specific. You have an exam, you get anxious. I have a presentation, I may be anxious, but it is very specific and it's not common to all the people. Now, why is anxiety very different? It has three properties. One is physiological, which means that I start feeling tension. My body, I start feeling either my pressure will be high, I feel tightness in my skin, I feel it in my shoulder, I get a headache, I may get cold. Many things will happen that are within your body. Behavioral is I want to do something, but I start to avoid. So I don't want to talk to my friend. I don't want to go and read my book. I have to study, but I don't want to study. And the most importantly, cognitive. Cognitive is at the mental level. I start worrying. My mood changes. I get irritable. So if my mother says, change the curtain, whole day you're sitting over there, you get angry. If someone tells you that what you're doing, what have you studied, have you done something, you get angry. So your mood changes completely. There's a lot of preoccupation. When I say preoccupation, which means that you start thinking like, what will happen? What will happen? I don't know what will happen. I don't know what to do. Now in fear, none of these things are there. In anxiety, all these three things are there. So when you get anxious, your body gets troubled, your behavior changes, and your mind also starts to get worried. Now, because everyone is not very familiar with all the three aspects, they will probably say, what is happening to you? Can't you just go and do something? Go and sleep, go and do this work, probably go and eat, watch TV, talk to your friend, you'll be all right. Now, that is something that we have to understand. Now, I'm asking you, are you afraid or are you anxious because of the lockdown? Many a times you say, I'm anxious. But sometimes you might be afraid. Now, the first self-check is while you're sitting and listening there, ask yourself, are you afraid or are you anxious? To answer the question myself, I was a bit anxious at the later stage, I was not afraid at all. So you must be able to say, I'm afraid, am I anxious? Now, if you say I'm afraid, what am I afraid of? If you are sitting there as a young adolescent, you might say, I'm afraid the exam didn't happen, or I'm afraid to talk in public, or I feel I'm frightened of what is going to happen to the world, to my job, to my admission. Whatever it is you're frightened about, talk to somebody, talk to your friend. Sometimes you may not, as an adolescent, you may not want to talk to your parent. You talk to a friend, talk to a friend who's maybe of your age. Sometimes talk to a cousin, talk to someone whom you trust. If you have a youth animator, if you have someone in this whole center at Girish that actually organizes programs, contact someone, talk to someone, pick up the phone and talk to a friend and work through it. Which means that if I have a fear of public speaking, then I cannot say I'm frightened. I talk to my friend. No, I will make a small speech. I'll make the speech in front of the mirror and see how frightened I am. After that, I'll make the speech in front of my friend. And later on, I'll make the same speech with my parents and my family. So working through it means making lots of efforts and working really hard to see how you can deal with it. Now, how to cope in this lockdown? First of all, you must ask yourself, what does this lockdown mean to me? The first time college told us on the 16th of March in the evening, y'all don't have to come to college. We'll come on the 25th. I was very, very happy. I didn't have morning exam. I didn't have morning lecture. And I thought some free time, because work has been hectic, teaching was hectic, and the 3 days students had off, they kept a seminar. So one must remember that when the lockdown started, everyone was shant and happy ki atta sutti betli kai pan karayla betta. So I was very happy that I don't have to get up at 5 o'clock. I don't have to climb the steps. I don't have to go to college. And I thought I will sleep more. That was my first reaction. And in mid-March, that is my first reaction. However, as March got over and April happened, then I still said, "Arey exam na hai, correction par na hai, varai." But we are starting to say now, what is the meaning of this? Because even you have free time, you can't go out, you can't meet your friend, you can only be in the house. You have to be careful how you shop. If you go out and shop, you have to follow some very basic procedures of wearing a mask, using a sanitizer. You have to maintain distance. When you come back, you have to not touch the things, sanitize. So by March, April, that was happening. In May, you had become used to the procedure and the routine. So it was still okay. Now it's June. College should have opened. Classes should have happened. And you realize nothing of that has happened. 3 months are over and many things have not really changed. So when you're discussing or dealing with yourself, find out. When the lockdown happened in March, what was my response? In April, what I was doing? In May, what I was doing? What is happening to me in June? Now, the only way you can find out is being in touch with yourself and trying to understand, have I been from beginning to end the same? I have not been the same, and that's what I'm telling you. Now, what can I do? So many a times you're sitting at home and thinking, I'm ready, Zali, ki mala kai tari hoto. Should I go and see a psychiatrist online? Should I Google mala kai tari manat hoto ka? Zop etna hai, mala khayla hotna hai. I have friends, mala kahits kaam nahi tari pan mala asa bara watat nahi. Every 3 mahina chi sutti asli pare, tari pan ami khush nahi. We are not happy. And you have to find out what is important that I can do. Now, you must recognize that the bear lives in the cave and many months he goes into hibernation. For me, the lockdown, it was a time to recharge. Another good example about the lockdown is this. The caterpillar grows wings during a season of isolation. Remember that you are in a period alone, but you also have time to recharge. For 2.5-3 months, I attended many training programs. I did a lot of reading. I learnt, and I saw how should I deal with my anxiety, how I should deal with my fear, what is it I need to do. And I think that all of you are like little cocoons. You are in the larva stage. After the lockdown, there'll be butterflies, not only in Vasai, the buzz of butterflies will come all over Mumbai. Now, how to manage this butterfly? How to become a butterfly? How can I ensure that I should be a butterfly? One is, I have to follow a routine. For 2 weeks, when I was at home, I slept. From a person who wakes up at 5 o'clock, I said, now I'll get up at 8 o'clock. Now I don't have to go anywhere. So for 2 weeks, I did that. And by the end of March, I realized that this is not going to be good. I have to change. So I changed my routine and I realized that I have to follow a routine of waking up little earlier. And it is something that I decide. So I have to follow a routine, which means that you decide, you wake up at 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock every day, wake up at a particular time. It is important to rest, but you have to eat at the same time. You have to eat while you're watching TV, not at all. Sit with your meal, talk to your parents, have your meal time together, have your rest time together. So the routine means set a routine to yourself. It's a timetable. Many times people don't realize that when they come to college, there's a timetable. They don't like it at all. But I think that just like a creche manages children, a timetable manages the adolescent. One class, next class, break, then some program, then something. So when you have a timetable, you are on line, as I would call it. You would wake up, catch a train, come to college, whichever college you went to. Then you come and sit for lectures. Then you have lunch. Then you have a break. You meet your friends. You go back home. You're tired. You rest. And then you have little relaxation, talking to your friend, watch TV, and you go to sleep. Some of you might exercise. Now, there is no room for exercise at all, necessarily, because we are not walking much. We are not climbing much. But we are in our house. So you develop your exercise routine in the place that you are. So your routine would be sleeping time, exercise time, meal time, and it has to be fixed. You become the master of your life just now, and you decide the timetable. The next thing you can do is you must rest. Don't read all the news. Don't read all the TVs, things that are there. Don't Google, don't go on WhatsApp all the time. After 9 o'clock, I put my phone away. I don't check it at all. If it's an emergency, then it's bad. But you have to rest. Rest means complete sleep. Learn to read. I know you may not read books, but I read many books in my house which I wanted to read and I had no time to read. So read. Reach out. When I say reach out, you have friends. So every day, call up your friends that you like. Also call up someone who might be alone in the parish, or a young person whom you feel that doesn't have friends. Sometimes in your parish, you might know that these people are not very poor, but just now there's a problem. Maybe their parents are rickshaw drivers. Maybe their parents are working in the beauty parlor, working in the gym. So they will have a problem with income or something. Reach out. They may not ask you money, but at least ask them, how are you coping? What is happening? Can I help you? Remember that the very poor get a lot of help from the government, from the church, and from everyone. Just now, the lockdown has made beggars of many people. And not everyone is going to put their hand out and ask for help. So you have to say, ki tyancha ghari problem ashelats. Apan kai karu shakto? So you have to reach out. Don't wait for somebody to come and tell you. You have to reach out. Repair. When I say repair your relationships, you have a problem with your brother, with your father, with your mother, spend little time. In 1 minute, it will not happen. But say that, you know, I was really angry that when I'm sitting, you're always telling me to do some work. I will do this work, but you tell me a time and tell me all the work that you need to do. Don't sarka sarka bolla tumhala avadat nahi. So repair means repair your relationships with people where you feel there's a problem. Reflect. In reflection, for me, the best story is, once again, this is a story of a man driving on a highway, and his car was very new, very fancy. As he was driving, suddenly a brick came from nowhere and smashed his windscreen. He was very angry. He stopped at the side. He pulled his car away and he was wanting to know that the brick came from where, because it was not a broom, it was not a branch, it was not a fruit. It was some brick that somebody had thrown. So he went around walking a little further, and just at the side, he saw this boy who was 12 years old. And the boy was standing there looking at him, very, very frightened. So the man came to him and told him, "What did you do?" So the boy said, "I threw the brick, so I'm very sorry." So the man started to shout at him and said that, "You know, this is my car. I've spent so much. Do you have any sense?" And the boy said, "I'm very sorry, sir. My sister is 5 years old. She's on the wheelchair. The wheelchair has fallen down, little down the highway. I can't pick it up. For a long time, I stood. I put my hand out to stop the car. No one was listening. It is half an hour and 45 minutes I'm standing here. My sister is in pain. I just need some help. And so I threw the brick." And when I talk about reflection and lockdown, what I'd like you to say, don't wait for somebody to throw a brick. The lockdown is about reflection, about God, the place of God in our life, the place of what we are doing to people, the way we are treating other people, whether it's community, religion, the entire way that we are living. So look at the way you're living your life currently. Are you living only for yourself? Are you looking out for others? You don't have to be a priest or a social worker to do social work. You don't have to be very special in that sense. Reflection is, what is my life? What do I want? And what am I thinking about it? And reflection, just now is the time for reflection. Even now we have not corrected. We have not corrected the mistakes that has happened. The government has failed in some ways. There are so many organizations, lots of parishioners, the Archdiocese of Bombay and Vasai, all of them have reached out to communities, and many individuals have spent money that they have from their salary, making a mask, providing food. And I think that when I reflect back, yes, the brick has been thrown on our face by the virus. But there is a lot of good in people, and that for me is the strongest thing, a part of the reflection. The other important part is...
Ma'am, sorry to interrupt. We have about 4 minutes left of this session. So okay. After this session ends, a kind request to all the participants to log in back with the details that have been given.
Okay.
May continue, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you. You also need to get some time off from gadgets. Keep a time. In the morning, in the night when you sleep, don't sleep with the phone. When you wake up, that's not the first thing that you put on and check. Spend some time in prayer, spend some time in exercise, have breakfast, then go on to your gadgets. Find out some hobbies that you like. Find out what you're interested in and change the goal. Suppose I had a goal, I want to go to America and study. Now that goal is not possible. Maybe I have a goal to search a new job. This may not be the best time to get a job. So when I say that what has helped me, what will help you to become a butterfly, it is routine, rest, read, reach out, repair, reflect, remove some time out from your gadgets, spend some time alone, develop your hobbies. I know we don't have access to anything, but see in your house, look if you can do some gardening, see if you can read something, make a photo album, download your photos, create an album, see if you can learn cooking. Cooking is the best skill you'll ever learn, not just for yourself, but also for others. Wherever you go, don't feel shy that you don't know to cook. Learn to cook. As people from Vasai, if you don't know to make chapati, roti, bhakri, learn that skill. It is something that will make you proud, and not because you have to be a good wife or you have to be a good husband. You have to learn it for yourself. When you go to America, when you're posted in a place and you have to be there. I've had students who say, "Today, ma'am, I ate boiled potato and tomorrow I'll eat beetroot and day after I'll eat Maggi." 1 week you can eat like that. 6 months to 1 year, young people from Vasai are going to study abroad. You have to learn to cook. If you don't know, take the best help from your mom. Take it from YouTube. You say, "Today I'll make a dessert. Today I'll make breakfast." Maintain it within the means. Don't go and say, "I have to buy this to make." Gharat kahi pan asel vastu tyani apan kai karu shakto te vichar karayche. All right? So please learn to cook, learn some exercise, check about the exercise if it suits your system, it suits your constitution. Don't copy very hard exercises. Check your age, check whether you have good, if you have some kind of things. Otherwise, you can do spot jogging, walking in the house, running, walking wherever you are in the garden and maintaining some kind of measures that are of safety. Now, these are ways that will actually help you a lot. Don't be like this. Don't say, when 2020 is over, then you tell me, then I will do something. So this is not going to be my response. And this is something that I have to pay attention to, that I am going to do something with my life, something more fruitful, something more productive, and not be so lazy that I sleep the whole day. I get up at 12 o'clock. I don't know what time is breakfast. I don't know lunch and breakfast is happening at the same time. 4 o'clock, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just finishing the day. 3 months are over and I have not learned anything. I don't even know what I am doing. So no one should say that, let me see, let me wait and see, let me see what can happen, let this be over, teva mi kai karnar. I will not absolutely wait for the time is over. 3 months is a long time. There are many online courses, some of them are free. Some of the things you can enroll and sit at home and learn, and that is something that you need to do. Fight your fears is to fight the fears, whatever you're dealing, whether it's, I don't know to make friends, I don't know how to learn a skill, I'm frightened of the water. I go to an instructor, I join a class, and I see that I can manage it within my means. I don't have to say ki I have to spend money. If I can learn with the help of a friend, then that is where I deal with my fear. Now, going on to something, you are in the safe place, your home. Even as a counselor, when I say this, I know that everybody's home is not safe. Today we have got the highest problems of violence, domestic violence and sexual abuse in the most safest place, your home. However, you have to be grateful that you have a roof above your head, you have a place, and if there is a problem that relates to either violence or abuse, please do not sit quietly. Reach out to someone in the community, reach out to a friend and take the help, because just now, probably God has given us some time to be at home, so we'll build our character. So when we come out of this lockdown, we'll probably be slightly better than we were. We'll be stronger. We'll have an idea of how to deal with life. And the most important thing is, when you're doing this, learn to be patient with yourself. So you can read this about the mountain. I'll give you about 2 minutes to read.
Ma'am, can you put it on slideshow mode?
This thing?
Okay. Yes. From current slide.
From current slide, I'll have to click.
No, just click on slideshow.
Yeah.
You see that option below, from current slide.
Yeah. It says it may not happen. Okay?
Yeah, now we can see, that's better.
Go back to screen.
The escape button on your keyboard.
Okay. All right. So, in conclusion, I'd like to say that no matter what your questions are, no matter what you want, you may ask, but please don't read too much, don't check too much of WhatsApp or news that's negative, especially when you read about a suicide. The reporting has not been fair. There's been lots of media ethics that have not been followed. And just now we are emotionally very, very fragile. So when you're in a place that's there with your family members for a long time, you'll feel slightly more fragile, little more disturbed. And when you read news that's negative, you will feel upset. One thing I need to tell you, that everyone who's depressed does not kill themselves. Some people do. They need a psychiatric help. They need a psychologist. And it's always important to talk to a psychologist. Your friend is nice to talk to, but she's of your age, he's of your age. Sometimes they have not lived life more than you. So they're 18, they're 16, they're 17, sometimes they're 23, but they are same age. So pudsa kay hai, tyana maitich nahi. It's important to talk to someone older that you trust so that they can show you the way, and confidentiality is always maintained. I'll take questions just now, Sanya.
Okay, ma'am. I will. There are some questions by our participants in the chat box. I will read out the questions.
Okay.
So the first question is. Yeah, you can stop the slide.
Okay.
So the first question is, ma'am, sometimes our parents or our friends quite don't understand our feelings and neglect it, saying it's all in our head. What should a person do when someone close to you doesn't listen or understand you?
So one of the things you need to do is, you can't share your feelings with everybody. You have to find the person. Now, if suppose X cannot understand you, then talk to somebody else. And sometimes the one who's very close to you, they lose objectivity. What happens is, to give you an example of objectivity, because we are emotionally attached to the person, they feel like, ah, mala hai kalta. We know how they are. They will come out of it and they'll be all right. So sometimes they don't give you that attention that you need to give. Now what happens is, you get angry, you get upset, and you feel, jawalchach manus mala samjun ghet nahi. Ani dusranchi kashala bolacha. So therefore you must try and say, can I talk to somebody? Sometimes talk to an outsider that you absolutely know that it's safe. And there are lots of helplines that are available. You will get the help required.
Thank you, ma'am. The next question is, though we are trying our best to not keep ourselves idle, there is an increasing amount of dissatisfaction due to a sort of productivity contest that everyone's trying to indulge in. How do you think we can combat that?
See, one of the things is, develop a routine. You don't have to do what other people are doing. While the lockdown was on, many psychologists and psychiatrists have gone for webinar and webinar. They have been speakers. They are very tired. And many a times, they are tired themselves, that now we need psychologists to help them. So no matter what, you are not in competition with anybody. You have to be better than yourself. So you must try and understand that, okay, I was 85% last time. So if I get 81, I should be happy. If I was 55, I can't say I'll be 85. If I get 58, I should be happy. So don't get into a conquest with others. And if divas bhar kaich kaich karaycha asa, you don't have to be busy. It's like a monkey. The mind is like a monkey. If you keep it busy, it will not tell you what you're feeling. So give some time for rest. Don't be in competition. You must be motivated with a goal. I want to do something, but I don't have to worry because my brother is doing, my sister is doing, my neighbors are doing, my cousins are doing. Maja peksha meets worry, but dusrancha peksha me evda he nahi karaycha ki me tyancha I haven't to reach that stage that I am running faster than you. I have to run fastest myself.
Thank you, ma'am. So next question is, how to deal with procrastination? We plan a lot but end up doing very little of our plan.
Okay, so procrastination is someone who has made a big timetable and not done anything at all. So the first step that you do is, don't write the timetable, don't write the whole plan for the day. Only make a simple thing and say that tomorrow at 10 o'clock, I will take a walk or I will read a book. So make the task simple, give a time, and you have to be responsible for that task. Because if you make something very complex, if you don't get up at 9 or 9:30, you can't say I will do this at 10 o'clock. I don't know what time you get up and what is the task. So make a plan that's reasonable, that it's small, it's measurable, and then you can continue with the next task.
Next. Thank you, ma'am. So next question. How do we shut down anxious thoughts that come in our mind, especially while sleeping, resulting in insomnia?
Okay, so if you suffer from insomnia, one of the things you must recognize is that you're very, very worried, your body is very stressed. One of the things is later by 7, 8 o'clock, don't drink tea or coffee, don't exercise, don't watch Crime Patrol, any horror series that disturb you. See, if you look at the birds and animals and all, by 6 o'clock, they all ghari etat and they're quiet, they quieten the system. Now, gradually they sleep by that time and they can wake up at 5. What we do, we come from work, we don't have proper meal. So we have a bigger meal at night. So that interferes with sleep. You have to eat your meal by 7 or 8 o'clock. 2 hours gap. If you eat late, you don't get sleep. Your body doesn't digest. You have to sleep by 10 o'clock. Your neurons actually generate and you are able to do really well because your sleep is also complete. So if you're not getting sleep, one of the things is check if you are sleeping in the same place, whether you're using your bed for studying, eating, everything. The bed has to be proper. It has to be used only for sleeping. Your room has to be clean. The lighting has to be okay. No phone, no television. Don't watch till 12, 1 o'clock. So one day I watch TV till 1, next day I watch till 2 o'clock. Your body follows a cycle and you will not be able to sleep if you don't set it on a cycle.
Okay, next question, ma'am. I was okay till Tuesday, but after the suicide of the actor, I read a lot of news in one day and I felt sick the next day onwards. I don't know how to deal with this. I've talked with almost everyone and kept myself busy with stuff. But then, as you said, I don't feel like doing anything. Can help me out because I am very positive about the situation and help my friends come out of the fear, and today I'm facing the same and struggling me.
All right. So now one of the thing is that when you go to buffet, appan keva, you know, we go to Fusion, we go to buffet, saatche, we pay 700, 800, 1000. But apli kevdi capacity hai, tevdach appan khau shakto. Buffet madhi paise dile tari appan tevda khau shakat nahi. Char desert asel, saat desert asel, pan appan khau shakat nahi. Similarly, the mind can cope with only little things. So when you go and when you read too much, you have already caused a little bit of damage. Now what will happen is it will take 3-4 days, no, it will take 7-8 days because the same thoughts and the record is going in your mind because the mind has a memory. So one of the things that you have to do is when you realize that the thought is coming, get up, wash your face, drink some water, go and do an activity. Don't talk to a friend, do some activity. Exercise, just walking in the house helps to keep the mind balanced a lot.
Thank you, ma'am. So next question. What happens when we don't acknowledge that we feel anxious and just plod along with trying to carry on?
When you feel anxious, you must know that. Like I get very anxious about online talks or lecture because I'm not sure of technology. You can check with any of my students. I use only chalk and board to teach. I don't even make a PPT. So I know I'm anxious about it. At the same time, I know the screen is on. People like to see something. You cannot talk. I talk very fast. So I have realized that I'm anxious about it. So I prepare, I plan, I do a practice with somebody. And then I tell them, tell me if something is okay. So once I do that, I feel less anxious. Now, if I don't accept that, I can say I'm a counselor, I'm a teacher, I have 25 years, I cannot be anxious, then that is denial. When I deny, the anxiety, which is a small thing, now becomes a disorder. So today for a lecture, I'll get anxious. Tomorrow, if someone tells me that I have to do an assignment, I'll get anxious. Tomorrow, my parent says you can go and bring something, I'll get anxious. So gradually, it becomes very, very big and it becomes unmanageable. So don't feel shy at any point of time to say that, okay, I'm frightened, I'm anxious, I'm worried. It's all right because these are things that we experience. If I say I'm hungry, then I'll get a signal from my body. I recognize it and I eat. Now, if I'm hungry, I get a signal and I don't feed my body for a long time, I can faint. So the same thing mentally, you must express your anxiety and say that you're feeling anxious.
Thank you, ma'am. Next question. Fear of losing someone and being sensitive is two dangers. How do we overcome this?
All right. Now, in terms of being sensitive, there are two levels. Don't bhag us. The one is, I am very sensitive. Mala koni kai bola to mala ekdamaj kharab vato. Means, I am sensitive, oversensitive. The second sensitive is when I am sensitive that migrants la jevan bhetla nahi, chalat chalat ghari gele. They walked home. Many of them have been injured. Some of them had accidents and died. Some never reached home. So sensitive is two levels. First, you must find out, am I sensitive to my needs or am I sensitive to other people? Now, the loss of someone is a very, very big loss and it's a huge thing. Until we lose someone, we may not be able to deal with it, but to be anxious to say ki asa honar honar, we can't control it. So we can't control it because it is not happened. It's not fully real. So I think that you must focus on what is the present situation. You have your parents. How are you treating them? Are you being nice to them? Or am I thinking that tana kai zhala ta maja kasa honar ki tyancha kasa honar? You have to think very, very clearly ki what am I worried about? Is it death? And the coronavirus has caused this fear of death. That is the biggest fear currently in the city and all across the world. Everyone is thinking that I don't want to die, and yet death is all around us. So it's a natural fear that is there, and it's not something that is abnormal. Nothing is wrong with you. It is all right to worry about it. It means that, okay, I have life. What do I do about my life? What are the things I can do? I should plan that.
Okay, so next question. Trying to carry on with normal activities like work from home, etc. It's difficult during the lockdown. Sometimes that results in anxiety too, as we don't get to work done or don't feel like doing it. How to deal with it?
Sometimes it depends on the nature of work. Sometimes because of the lockdown, I know lots of offices are giving more and more work. In the office, what happens? Or in college, when you're doing work, so don't shabd apan kunashi bolto, hasto, chalat jato, chai pito. You're now, every time there's lots of work, you don't get up. And everyone think, ha, tu aram kartos, kai kaam, tumhala kai kaamach nahi. So what happens, you start getting angry, you get upset. And your boss and all say that, ha, ghari chai na kute, jayachas nahi, he karun de, te karun de. So what happens is, you start feeling angry actually, and you're not just upset. Because you're getting angry, somebody is not understanding you. As a result of which, you feel a little bogged down and you feel like, you know, I'm not feeling like working. What happens? The environment is new. I have never sat down and given a lecture in 25 years. For 3 hours and 4 hours and even 7 hours, I stand. Now I have to sit down because of the laptop. So it's new to me. It's unusual. I have slowly accepted it. But it is a change, and change doesn't happen overnight. It takes a lot of time. So by the time you adjust to lockdown and work from home, the lockdown will be over and you will feel ki maje paya tak chalat nahi, kamala kasa jayacha, jayacha ki nahi jayacha. That vichar will come in your hand.
Okay, ma'am. Next question. What measures should a person take when somebody is going through their fears and anxiety, and how to help them overcome this?
See, one of the things is find out whether the fear is very real, whether it relates from illness. Sometimes the fear is about illness. Sometimes it's the fear of a parent illness. Now you can listen to them. You have to listen to them. You can tell them a few steps like following routine. Check first. Ki zop barabar ait ho ki na ait. Are you eating properly? Are you spending some time in exercise? Exercise is a very good tip to keep your mind healthy. And I'm not telling you gym. Sada skipping rope, do skipping for 5 minutes, walk. It is all right. Two things that will help is exercise and maintaining a routine. Trying to see if you can sleep. See what happens is we're at home, we're eating, we're no exercise, we don't get sleep. And when we don't get sleep, the monkey is very active. The vichar eto manat. And it hijacks us. And then we read, if you have read a lot of information about something negative, about the suicide, you know, it is not needed. Sushant Singh is not God. He's a young person who lost his life. You are feeling sad. But do you read autobiographies so detailed? Do you need to know so much? No, you don't need it at all.
Yes, ma'am, so we have two more questions left.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so one is, as far as I understand, fear and anxiety are two similar concepts. Can you please help us know the difference between the two and how anxiety works? What is difference between fear and anxiety?
Fear is very, very current, and it's very it's related to something. I'm fear of lizard, snake, loud noise. It's of emotion. So I'm frightened to go and talk to some stranger. That is very, very concrete. Manje aplyala maiti asto ki what I'm frightened about. Once I learn that, I can do something to overcome the fear. Anxiety is continuous. मनात विचार आणि अख्खा दिवस शरीराला पण त्रास आणि टेन्शन विच मीन्स आय डोंट रियली नो की काय होत आहे आय कांट अंडरस्टँड इट्स ऑलवेज अबाउट द फ्युचर आय कांट ऑलवेज अंडरस्टँड अँड रेकॉग्नाइज इट सो एन्झायटी इज डिफरंट इट्स नॉट एन इमोशन इट्स नॉट कॉमन एव्हरी वन डझंट फील अँक्शियस समबडी गेट्स अ इन्व्हिटेशन टू अ पार्टी सो they are very happy and they start thinking me I will wear this who will be there what shoes I'll wear maybe I have to go and buy something they are very happy someone else has got an invitation they are anxious now if they are anxious what will happen they'll say ki mala jayachach nahi and you feel like party aahe kashala jayacha nahi and they are people who are anxious because they are anxious about people and meeting people they are worried about what people think about them and therefore anxiety is very very different when you are frightened you can identify the fear in anxiety many times you can't identify the anxiety so one of the things is to recognize is something happening to your mind is something happening to your body and you will get proper signals when you eat you may have diarrhea you go to the washroom many times if your respiratory system is different you'll sneeze a lot suddenly your head will pain you get a cough all these are symptoms little bit of how anxiety is expressing itself so you must say did I have an assignment do I have a presentation is something happening is did I have a fight with my partner so is something happening did somebody say to me then I start getting anxious so if in the lockdown your partner has said something you feel ki mala sodnar ki to ti anxiety tyacha kadun pan yeto
so there are more few questions coming up ma'am so what we can do is we can start with the new meeting we can log in again
Okay.
With the same link?
No, I will share the link again on the group, on the chat.
You can use the time. There is time. 7 minutes are remaining.
7 minutes are remaining, yeah, right.
So you can use the time.
We will share the link on chat also.
Yeah, sure. Okay, Sanya, can you take over?
Okay, ma'am. The next question is, sharing requires vulnerability. What if the very thought of being vulnerable to someone again brings out anxiety attacks or the overwhelmness in you due to some past traumatic experiences?
This will require help and professional help. As I said, suppose you have shared something and everyone has talked about it because somebody you have shared with has not really kept the confidentiality. So I'm really sorry that this has happened to you, but one needs to try again. If I don't try, I will remain where I am. If the larva says I'll be in the cocoon ikade baro vatte, then we'll never see the butterfly. I have to grow, I have to take the step, and I cannot make a us drink water I can bring it to the river and say pani pi pan tyacha nantar apan kahi karu shakat nahi so you must come out of this and make some attempt so what you can do is find somebody you trust find somebody that you think you will trust and give them a small probably share something small that's not very very personal and see how you feel when I meet you for the first time You can't tell me everything about your life story because you don't know me, I don't know you. So little bit of care you should see in do I know the person. If he is a professional counselor, yes, I can share. If it's only my friend, if it's from the Vasai place, if it's only from this area, so then you can probably check.
Next question. Youth are constantly anxious about a lot of things. They also fear what will happen tomorrow, especially in today's circumstances. How do we assure ourselves and others that everything is going to be fine, even if it doesn't sound convincing today?
What you need to do is that today neither the government or anyone, nobody actually knows what is going to happen, and no one knows how to deal with life. वी डोंट नो इफ वी विल लिव फॉर टुमॉरो मग पुढचं एन्झायटी कशावरून आता तुम्ही काय करता व्हॉट आर यू डुईंग जस्ट नाउ अबाउट टुडे मेनी टाइम्स वेन समबडी डाईज वी ऑफन फील दॅट अरे आय शुड हॅव डन दिस आय कुड हॅव डन दिस बट द पर्सन इज देअर नो विथ यू So while you are there, please focus on the present. Don't try to plan the future because no one can plan the future today. And that is something that we all have to accept. Just now, you must remember that we are all Christians, at least the ones who are listening in Vasai. We also believe in God. And I think that for me as a person, as a psychologist, I have learned much from religion. You may not read the Bible, but this is a line that I get peace with. And it says that be still and know that I am God. So you can do a reflection of 5-10 minutes on be still and know that I am God and you will learn a lot about yourself. Do I have to leave the meeting?
There are 3 minutes, then we can wind up within 2 minutes. Okay. Another 1 minute reaction we can have and we can wind okay. up because
yeah then no
we
problem
have said them though there is another meeting schedule but we'll try to wind up because there are no questions coming up.
Okay no problem okay
so any concluding message that you want to give to our youth
concluding message is believe in yourself trust in God spend time in prayer eat well look after yourself and then look after others because the principle of first aid is first help yourself then help the others
ma'am thank I you. Think those were about it those were the questions yeah, no that problem. Were there
thank okay. you
Enron I think we might not need another session then
okay no problem thank you Sania and Rehan especially thank you Father Alwyn for the opportunity it was nice working with you all thank you
Somebody's thanking you, so I'll not overpower you.
Okay, Enron, I think we can have a vote of thanks.
Okay, a sweet end to the program is a vote of thanks. On behalf of each and everyone present here, I would like to express my gratitude to our speaker, Ms. Linda, for enlightening us on the topic fear and anxiety, and for helping us understand the way to overcome the fear in ourselves, and for precisely responding to our questions too. Secondly, a big thanks to Father Alwyn and the Yuvadarshan core team for organizing such a platform for us to learn and become awareness agents. Finally, I would like to thank all of you present over here for attending and being the part of this session. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye.
Friends, सगळ्यांनी लवकर एंड केलेलं आहे कोणी एक एंडिंग नोट देतो लिंडा मॅमला मी जेव्हा कॉल केला तेव्हा त्यांनी फर्स्ट कॉललाच सांगितलं फादर आय वॉन्ट टू डू अ लॉट फॉर आर युथ एस्पेशली फॉर देअर लाईफ इन द फ्युचर आणि खऱ्या टीचरचं खरी शिकवणूक अशी दिसून येते टीचर इज नॉट जस्ट की मला माझं सगळं आहे ते मिळते असं नाही शी इज बॉदर्ड अबाउट द लाईफ ऑफ द पीपल आणि ते खरं मॅम तुमच्या जीवनामधून आम्हाला दिसून आलेलं आहे अँड तुमचं खूप सेशन आवडलेलं आहे दो काही गोष्टी आपण फमिलियर नसतो लाईक ऑनलाईन तुम्ही फमिलियर नसताना सुद्धा इतक्या चांगल्या प्रकारे तुम्ही हँडल केलेलं आहे वी से ऑल द बेस्ट टू यू फॉर द फ्युचर अँड थँक्यू व्हेरी मच फॉर द डेप्थ ऑफ आर हार्ट फॉर बिईंग विथ अस अँड गाईडिंग आर यूथ कंटिन्यू टू गाईड अँड इन्स्पायर मेनी पीपल हुम यू मीट इन युअर लाईफ थँक्यू व्हेरी मच
थँक्यू थँक्यू थँक्स सानिया अँड रेहान स्पेशली
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. It
was a pleasure to have you.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Bye.
Bye, ma'am. Just a note to the participants, all those who have registered for tomorrow's session, we'll begin at 5 p.m. on Google Meet. The session will happen as usual on Google Meet. It is Father Chetan's session tomorrow. Okay, thank you for joining us today. Bye, take care.